Myanmar is in the cusp of change. After years of a repressive regime, it is taking a big step, a huge leap towards democracy. Isolated and cut off for decades, the doors of Myanmar are now open. I'm Corina Sanchez. Join me in this exclusive special, ANC Presents Myanmar Opens to the World. A land of hills, valleys, mountain ranges, long rivers, and vast flatlands. A land glistening with golden pagodas, colonial buildings, and bustling markets. A land made up of 135 ethnic groups, and one of the most genteel peoples in the world. This is Myanmar. Located in Southeast Asia, Myanmar is bordered by China, Laos, Thailand, Bangladesh, and India. With a population of over 15 million, it has a unique charm, natural beauty, and a vibrant culture. About 9 of 10 Myanmar nationals are Buddhists. With its many temples and pagodas, a testament to the people's deep faith. In the early 1800s, Myanmar was colonized by Britain. It would not gain independence from the British until 1948, when it became the Union of Burma, an independent republic. But in 1962, the military took control of government through a coup d'etat. For decades, the people of Myanmar were mired in poverty. And witnessed human rights abuses, the violent dispersal of student protests, and the detention of political leaders and pro-democracy advocates. Among them, Aung San Suu Kyi, the face and lonely voice of opposition in Myanmar. Despite international pressure and economic sanctions, the isolationist government continued to lock out Myanmar from the world. Until 2010, when the new president vowed to walk towards democracy and open Myanmar to the world.
Exactly, it started in 1988, September 18. Because during that time, the military had take over the country to prevent the disintegration of the country. And during that time, the Tamador, or military leader, promised to change our political system from one-party system to the multi-party democratic system. So since then, we try to implement this process, but because of the internal political conflict, there's a lot of obstacle to do that. In 2003, the government announced a seven-step roadmap, and they restarted the national convention to lay down the fundamental principle for the new constitution. And after the 2008, the people approved the new constitution with the referendum, and then the 2010 election coming. And then 2011, the State Peace and Development Council transferred the power to the new government elected by the people.
Among the reforms, the push for a free press.
The president clearly said the media will be the very important role in the new democratic society in our country. They will become the true fourth pillar of our society. So now we are trying to change our media law for this new media environment.
Despite the stream of visits from world leaders, including U.S. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton in 2011, both the international community and the people of Myanmar are not yet fully convinced of the new government's sincerity and motives in implementing the reforms.
We are prepared to go further if the reforms maintain momentum.
We will learn from the rest of the world, and we hope that the rest of the world will also find some things to learn from us.